kilometers altitude back down to the ground. As a reminder, Starship 10 is one in a series of Starship vehicles that we have built to gather this test data. Today's flight will be very similar to the one just over a month ago, Starship 9, except today, just before we land, we plan to ignite all three Raptor engines to help flip the vehicle, and then we will shut engines down to support the landing on the landing zone just adjacent to the launch pad that you see right here. But right now, coming up at T-minus 3 minutes, everything continuing to go well for the flight of Starship 10. T-minus 90 seconds and counting on the test flight of Starship number 10. Propellants, methane, and liquid oxygen are now fully loaded on board the Starship, pressurizing the vehicle, getting ready for the ignition of the three Raptor engines at T0, and then liftoff. We'll be flying to an altitude of 10 kilometers in today's test flight. T-minus 30 seconds and counting. Everything continues to go well for the test flight of Starship 10. We have disconnected the quick disconnect from the vehicle, getting ready for the ignition of the three Raptor engines.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, ignition. Abort. All right, all folks, please triage alarms. Copy, total thrust abort. Outside of expected bounds, Raptor.
John Innsbrucker here on the webcast. You can see with clock on the screen, we were down to zero. We ignited the three Raptor engines. The ground sequence did declare an abort from the vehicle. We're listening in right now, but that will conclude today's test flight activities. We are currently safing the vehicle. We're looking at what the telemetry tells us about the abort, but given where we are in today's window, I expect this will conclude our countdown activity for today.